All right, now our Angular application has been installed properly, and inside the Angular app folder, we have another folder with the same name of Angular app. So I'm going to right click on it and go to the Git bash here. So I'm going to open my Visual Studio Code. So if you have installed the Visual Studio Code and following along with me, that will be great. So you just simply need to insert the command for the code dot, and that will open the Visual Studio Code. All right. And once we have opened our Visual Studio Code, we have our bunch of files for our Angular application. So that includes all the root directory files for our Angular application. So the name of the folder is Angular app, and inside there are a bunch of files. So I'm going to explain you the file structure here. All right, so there are a lot of files for the Angular, but most of the stuff you don't need to mess with that. So here we have a file with the name of tsconfig.json. So basically this file, that what output you want TypeScript to compile to, which now is ES5. So if I just go inside it, now you see that we have the target for ES5. That means that the version, the TypeScript to compile is ES5. For the maximum browser compatibility. All right, so next we have a file with the name of tslint.json. So what actually it's going, it's basically going to the going for the TypeScript, but we don't need to mess with that. So most of the files are like testing files for the JavaScript, so we are not going to explain that. This is not in our course. Okay, so then we have our file with the name of package.json, which is right here. So it is one of the most important file in the root directory, is package.json. And there you find that we have the name, the versions. Basically, if you ever worked on node.js, so you when you're doing npm init, and they want to ask you about the version, the name of the application, here you see, and also down here we have the scripts. So scripts are like the shortcut for doing the certain things, like npm start to start the server, which is really a nice feature in Angular application. And down we have our ng-serve to run the server. Ng-build means you can deploy your website. It's gonna compile a bunch of static assets you can just upload to your server. All right, so these are the files. And down here we have some E2E and the link for the testing framework for the Angular. And dependencies, we have a lot of dependencies in an Angular application. So, which are basically animation, common, compiler, core, forms. So these are all the libraries or libraries inside the Angular. So forms for the form module, core, which Angular works for the core, which works for the critical part of the application. Platform dash browser for the bootstrapping, and the router for navigation. So there are many other bunch of files inside that. And also you find RxJS. So RxJS, which is the reactive extension so that it gives the capability to use observables in work of data streams, all right? And down here we also have the dev dependencies, are the dependency in which are only used for the development. So we have Jasmine, and some Jasmine core, and much more stuff for the, and also some testing frameworks down here. Okay, so this is a very simple explanation about all those things inside the package.json, which comprises of a lot of libraries inside it. All right, so now we have another folder, node underscore modules, node modules, where all our dependencies exist. So we are not gonna touch these files, right? So inside the app source folder and the app folder, we have some very important stuff. So index.html here, you see this is which is the core file that's loaded into the browser, and this is the app-root, basically, which is the custom directive where our application Angular application is inserted. We also have the main.ts file, if I want to go up there. So there you find we have the main.ts file, and which takes care for bootstrapping the app module. So if you look into the app folder, and inside the app folder we have the TypeScript files, we have the module file. So this is where all our components go, services, pipe, things which you need for our regular application. This is where you see app.module.ts file, And this is where all our components goes inside. So whenever we are going to generate a new component through CLI, you find that the component automatically generated. So the components goes into the declaration, and here you see the array and G module. This is basically a lifecycle hook, and inside the ng module we have the declarations, we have the imports. The imports goes in, all the modules go inside the imports, and the providers, all the services go inside the providers, and we have our browser module, which actually runs our which basically view all the results on the DOM, document object model. So Angular Core, which is the library where all the critical part of the application works. And then we can, if inside the app.component.html, this is what you see on the browser and all the title and all the links on the down. So now I'm going to run the server by running ng serve, not the ng serve. All right, now press enter. Okay, now you see that we have our Angular application loads on the port number 4200. So if it's not automatically open, just so you can on the browser, just simply type localhost colon 4200 so that want to run your Angular application on the browser. All right, so these are the components. So just explaining you again, the components are like the basic building block in an Angular application. So components are components have the at the rate decorator and the right component decorator. So if I want to go inside that, you see that this is actually a decorator. A component has a selector, template, styles, and other properties which it specifies the metadata required to process the components. So if I find here, this is the custom root, custom directive for the selector and whatever the name of your file. So that app is the pre and the dash, the name of your file. Then we have our template URL where we have to load our HTML file, style URLs for the CSS files. Okay, then we export that, and this is our title, so Angular app. And if I want to go up there, and you see that this is the name of our application. So whatever you see here, it's actually loaded from here. So if I want to change that to Ambula and saves it, now refresh this, and notice you see. Now it's Abdullah. All right. So now we will explain all the basics about the Angular application in the next section. So that's it. I want to see you in the next part.